Well, welcome back to Steve Robb Reviews. Today, I'm going to start on a project I should have done a long time ago. And it involves this right here. This is some pipe. This here is just under 4 feet long. And it looks about maybe 5/16 wall. And I'm going to start on this project where I am planning on designing a mast to go in the ground. I've got a three-point hitch auger for the back of my tractor, and I'm going to mount this pole in the ground for my solar panel. I've got 4 100-watt solar panels that I want to mount, and I thought, you know what? What I'm planning on doing is having it so that I can actually put this up myself, take it down myself, because it's going to be quite heavy. And I got some other pieces here. I'll show you what I got planned. You guys take a look. Let me know what you think. Okay, as you can see here, I got the pipe sitting on two pieces of steel angle iron. And these are 3/8 thick, 2 inches on each end. You know, 2 inches this way, 2 inches this way. And the total length of these are 36. Now, what I'm planning on doing is having this pipe come back to approximately here and weld this right to the pipe. And this will be the backstop. And I'm going to have a plate here, and I'm going to have a hinge here so that I can get the mast and lift it all the way up and have it fit right in here, nice and flush, and then somehow have two bolts or something here that will bolt this down in four areas. Like I say, this section here is only showing out about 9 inches, but I'm gonna actually go, you know, probably 20 inches. And of course, the rest of this will be buried in the ground. And I'm thinking, you know what? When I pour the concrete to go into the ground, I want the concrete to go up into the tube. So I'm gonna do a couple of things on there. But what we have to do first is we have to actually weld these angle iron pieces to the tube, and I have to prep it all up. I have to sand the outside pieces and get all the rust off, and then we'll start welding and we'll see how that goes. But the distance in between here is just a shy over 3.5 inches, so I was thinking on getting maybe a mast that was going to be, say, 2 by 3. If I can get 3.5, that'd be fine. I'm not too sure about the structural steel, whether it comes in a 3.5. If it does, it'll fit in there perfectly. And we'll see how that goes. But let's just start now with figuring where this is going to go exactly. Sanding it all down, getting the rust all off. And then we'll start welding. Well, this one I got hooked up so far. I just used this chalk marker for making my lines. I tried putting it down here, and then I tried here, and I decided on having 20 inches above ground. So what I got to do is I'm going to mount this on one side here, and then of course I'll just go over to the other side where it completely matches up, so it's nice and square. And as you can see here, I got a buzz off all the mill scale on this here, and now I got a nice spot where I can take all the rust off here. So I'll bring you back when that's all done, and we'll have her all prepped to go. So let's get to her. Well, there we go right there. I'm telling you, you know, that's an old piece of pipe, and it's quite rusty as well. Man, oh man, was that a lot of dust. So, and you can see I've just sanded down both the edges there. Okay, let's put her on. Let's get her tacked on. Okay, I got it all set up. I had to grind a spot at the end of the pipe there so my ground clamp would actually have a good connection. And I'll zoom you in here so you could see what I got going on. Well, she's clamped down there pretty good, as you could see. And I'm just going to put a couple of tacks on both sides. I'll start off with this side first and move over to the other side. And this thick of a piece of steel, I'm not worried about going back and forth. I'll just put three beads on this side, three beads on the other. Okay, let's flip her over, do the other side. Okay, how's that look right there? Let's just tacky-tacky, here we go. Okay, I'll bring you back when I got her all welded up and we'll take a look at the other side. Well, I'll show you what I got done so far. I did put two passes on this, and I'll just show you. I mean, it's not fancy welds, guys, but it's just going to hold that in there nice. And of course, some might be wondering, like, why don't you weld it continuously all the way down? And what I've been taught over the years is you're better off to stagger them like that, because if you get a break in one, it'll just rip all the way down to the end where it'll stop at the next weld usually. So that's all I'm going to put in there. And I mean, this is going to be plenty heavy duty. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to stab the other one on there. So I'm not going to bore you showing that, but I'll bring you back when I got that part done too. Well, this is it right here. This is all complete what I'm going to do so far. She's nothing fancy, guys. I'm not the best welder in the world, I'll tell you that for sure. But I think that's going to work out all right. You know, I don't think that's going to be bad at all. She's still a little warm. But yeah, I think that's going to work all right. I'm going to stand this up now, and I'm going to show you what my idea is. Okay, guys, this is the whole idea. From here down is going to be in the ground with some concrete. And I was figuring on mounting a plate right here, and then having my main beam be hinged off of this plate. So when it's laying down along the ground and the solar panel mount at the end with the solar panels is on there, I can just lift it up into here and I'll have bolts, four bolts, mounting it down so this doesn't go anywhere. Does that make sense to you? You guys think this is heavy enough? I think it's heavy duty enough. I mean, I'm thinking 3/8 thick is plenty. And I figure that this tower is going to probably be about 12 feet tall. This, like I say, from here down the ground is going to be in concrete. And I'm going to do something to the bottom here. I'll show you in the next vid how I'm going to get the concrete inside the post too. And I thought I wanted to do that rather than just have it go around the outside. This is all buried anyways. So you guys let me think. Is this okay to you or what? I've never done one of these before. And it's just going right off top of my head here. I think this is going to be a good idea, and it'll be a nice project for the summer. I like to get as many projects as I can get done. I got a short period of time up at my camp, and I think this is going to work out great. I just don't know where I'm going to put it, because if you guys ever seen that vid where I tried to put the ground rod in the ground, man, that was a pretty difficult vid to do, and I've got rock all over my place. But I've got a postal logger this time on the back of my tractor, and it's going to make it easier to make the holes. A lot easier than it was putting in them ground rods. So come back again and let's see how we're doing little further up the line when I get more built on this. I don't know how far I'm going to get this year, but this is going in the ground, that's for sure. And you guys come back again. Let's have some more fun, guys. Cheers.